Hi, my name is Nadine Malak. I'm a nuclear radiologist at Oregon Health and Science University, and I will be showing a case of ureteropelvic junction obstruction. Our patient is a 2-year-old girl with a history of recurrent febrile urinary tract infections. Ultrasound was done first, and it shows right hydronephrosis with cortical thinning of the right kidney. The left kidney, on the other hand, is unremarkable, with normal cortical thickness and no hydronephrosis. The patient was referred for a MAC3 renal scan. The perfusion phase of the MAC3 scan at 3 seconds per frame shows decreased perfusion to the right kidney in the green contour and normal perfusion to the left kidney in the yellow contour, and this reflects in the renal flow curves. Dynamic excretion images at 1 minute per frame for 20 minutes show decreased cortical uptake in the right kidney and normal cortical uptake in the left kidney. By the end of the 20 minutes, there is radiotracer accumulation in both collecting systems with no significant spontaneous washout, as we can see as well on the time activity curves. At this point, we give Lasix to evaluate for obstruction versus patulous non-obstructed collecting system. Post-Lasix images at 2 minutes per frame for 30 minutes show prompt emptying of the left collecting system, which reflects on the time activity curve with the post-Lasix half-time of 7 minutes, which indicates the absence of obstruction and is consistent with patulous non-obstructed collecting system. On the right, however, there is persistent accumulation of tracer in the collecting system without visible washout into the ureter. This reflects in a very prolonged post-Lasix half-time and is consistent with significant obstruction. So the final diagnosis is right ureteropelvic junction obstruction. This could be congenital or acquired. It can be due to intrinsic narrowing or to extrinsic compression, typically due to a vessel crossing at the lower renal pole. The diagnosis can be made incidentally, for example on screening ultrasound in perinatal period or in asymptomatic adults, having imaging done for other indications. When symptomatic, it can present with flank or abdominal pain, nausea, vomiting, renal stones, or recurrent pyelonephritis. Differential diagnosis when hydronephrosis is present includes ureteropelvic junction obstruction, which is the case here in the right kidney, or patulous non-obstructed renal collecting system, which is the case in the left kidney. Technetium-99M MAC3 scan with Lasix is the method of choice to differentiate between both entities. So the take-home messages, MAC3 scan with Lasix is the method of choice to evaluate for obstruction in the setting of hydronephrosis. An adequate response to Lasix with a post-Lasix half-time of less than 10 minutes indicates the absence of obstruction. A half-time of more than 20 minutes indicates significant obstruction. And if the half-time is between 10 and 20 minutes, this is indeterminate, and patients may require follow-up since obstruction might occur with time. MAC3 scan also allows quantification of differential function between both kidneys. A differential function of less than 40% in the affected kidney or a drop of function of more than 5% on subsequent scans indicate renal function deterioration. Thank you very much for watching.